Please come in and take a seat. It's really nice to meet you. How are you doing today? That's good to hear. Yes, I'm very well, thank you. I hope I didn't keep you waiting for too long. No, that's good. So I've set up a notepad, pen and some water for you. Do you need anything else? No? Okay, well if you need anything else throughout our interview to make you feel comfortable, just let me know. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Marina and I'm a senior recruiter here at Celestial & Co. and I'll be conducting your interview today. So I always like to do this with my candidates before I start, is to kind of give you an idea of what I'd like to cover today, if that's okay. Yeah, fantastic. So what I want to do is essentially review your background and experience so I can decide whether the job is suited to your talents and interests. So I'd like to hear about your job, education, interest, outside activities, and anything else you'd like to tell me. And after we've covered your background, I would like to spend some time answering any questions that you might have. Does that all make sense? Yeah? Fantastic. And just to note that as we go through the questions, I'll be writing down your answers on my computer. So don't worry if I'm just typing away and I'll still be listening fully, just noting things down. Okay. With the questions, what I would recommend is taking your time really to understand what I've asked you and ask to clarify anything you're not sure of. And then one thing that can be really helpful is to use the STAR method to respond to any sort of behavioural based questions. So you discuss the specific situation, task, action and the result. So that's something that can hopefully help you. But if you need a minute or two to think about your response, that's absolutely fine. Does that all make sense now? Yeah. So are you ready to start this time? Yeah, perfect. Let's go for it. Start with, can you tell me about yourself? So tell me about the job you're in now, kind of how your career has progressed to this point, what you're looking for in the future. And I always like to ask, what are kind of your hobbies and interests outside work? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's very interesting. Okay, fantastic. And what would you say are your key strengths? What are some areas you'd like to improve on? Okay. Great. And why do you want this job? Would you like to be in your career 5 years from now? Okay, fantastic. And what would be your ideal company to work for. Okay, and following on from that, what attracted you to this company? And why should we hire you? Okay. And when have you been the most satisfied in your career? Tell me, why are you leaving your present job? Makes sense, yeah? What do you know about this industry? Oh wow, you know quite a lot. That's really good. And then what do you know about our company? Oh fantastic, I can see you've really researched about us. That's really good. Positive thing. So now we're going to move on to some behavioural questions. So this would be the perfect time to use a star technique that I mentioned, but feel free to answer it in any way you think is suitable. So what was the last project you led and what was its outcome? Okay, thank you. Can you give me an example of a time that you felt you went above and beyond the call of duty at work? Oh, that's a really great example. Can you describe a time when your work was criticized? And have you ever been on a team where someone was not pulling their own weight? How did you handle it? Give someone difficult feedback. How did you handle it? Yeah. Okay. And what would you say is your greatest failure, and what did you learn from it? I know this one can be a bit tricky, so take your time if you need a few seconds. And if you were at business lunch and you ordered a rare steak and they brought it to you well done, what would you do? I thought there was a fun one there. Situation if you were required to finish multiple tasks by the end of the day and there was no conceivable way that you could finish them. Okay. And if you found out that your company was doing something against the law, like fraud, what would you do? Okay. If you had a choice between two superpowers, being invisible or flying, which would you choose? Interesting, yeah. And what was the last gift you gave someone? Okay. And how many square feet of pizza are eaten in the world each year? So don't worry about the exact number. The most important is telling me how you'd kind of work it out. Yeah? Okay. That's a bit tricky one. You're doing really well, don't worry. Doing really well, don't worry at all, honestly. I know it's a bit of a tricky question, but you answered that really well. And if you could compare yourself with any animal, which would it be and why? Okay. And if you could have dinner with any two famous people, dead or alive, who would you choose? Yeah. Oh, that's a really good choice. And what was the best work day you've ever had? Say, hypothetically, we finish this interview and you step outside of the office and you find a lottery ticket and you win £10 million. What would you do? Okay. And if you were a tree, what kind of a tree would you be and why? And then, if you were a lizard, what would you be? Oh, that's a great answer. Love it. Fantastic. What is a song that best describes you and why? When you go on holiday, when do you pack your case? Cool. And if aliens landed in front of you and in exchange for anything you desire, offered you any position on their planet, what would you want? And if someone wrote a biography about you, what do you think the title should be? Interesting. And what would you choose as your last meal? Define your personal work-life balance in terms of ratio. So is it sort of 50-50, 70-30? What would you say is for you? Okay, that's fair enough. And if you could be any superhero, which one would you be? What's your favourite flavour ice cream and why? What did you want to be when you were 10 years old? How would you describe yourself in 3 words? And how would your colleagues describe you in 3 words? And what about your friends? Okay, perfect. What would you do if you had a time machine? I wanted to ask you, do you have any questions for me? Sure, go ahead. Oh, that's a really good question. So I think the best thing about working here is really the people that I get to interact with. So everyone's really friendly here, and so it's a great environment to work in. And they're always willing to help you, so I think that's a really positive thing. So for me, it would be the people. And there's like a ton of social committees that you can get involved with to really get to know everyone within the business and have fun at the same time. So yeah, that's what I would say is the best thing about working here. Okay, so in terms of career progression, we do have a progression for you in this role if you were to get it. from associate to manager level, and we've got tons of training that we run throughout the year that help associate get to that manager level. So it is something possible, and you've got the support and training available, and that would kind of be your career path there. Any other questions? No? Okay. That's the end of the interview. I want to thank you for coming in today. I was honestly so impressed with all your answers, and I've actually never done this before after just one interview with a candidate, but I would actually like to offer you the role. So a big congratulations. I think your answers were fantastic, and I really see you as a cultural fit here within our team. So well done. And I'd like to, of course, offer you the job if that would be something you're interested in. How does that sound? So if you're happy to accept, do you mind just popping over to reception, where our office manager will be preparing your contract for you to sign? Oh, this is such great news. I can't wait to work with you. I'll pop over to reception in a bit. See you in a minute.